that, so we know idle fuel's good, idle spark's good, idle control is good. But let's take a look at startup. Let's also take a look at the actual park position in terms of the idle control here. So let's close out our spark timing. Jumping in here to idle settings, we have our IEC ramp down I want to discuss and our startup IEC position. So IEC parked is what we need to take a look at here in a warm idle. So now that we know everything is sorted out for fuel and spark, let me go ahead and shut this off here. Let's talk about their IEC park position. A little bit hard to talk over that blower. It's super loud on this car. We're finding we're at 180 coolant temp. And we can see here we're saying we want 50% in airflow contribution from the idle control motor. We know that the idle control motor is adjusted properly. We were in that 10-20% range when the engine is warm now. So what this is going to do on starting, this is going to bring the idle control up to 50% of the travel, allow 50% more airflow, or set 50% of the total airflow contribution from the idle control motor. This is the equivalent of opening the throttle plate with your foot and cranking the engine over. If we're finding that the engine's struggling to start, and you have to go and give it some gas, you'll go after your IEC park position. Let's go ahead and crank it up here warm. Let's see how it fires off and it runs. If we actually take a look at our idle control here and take a look at our IEC position, we see it's parked at 50. That's because we've command at 50. But command 70 in here, that's going to be where it commands from. Now, tied into this table is going to be how it decays out of the start mode. So if we go back here to settings, we take a look at startup IEC position. It'll hold 4 seconds worth of 50% position as we're starting it off at this coolant temp, and then it'll decay it out over 4 seconds. Let's see how this is going to react when we're going in and just testing this on our engine. If we're finding that the engine idle speed hangs kind of high and then it tapers out slowly, we might go here and reduce the hold time down to from 4 seconds to 2 seconds, and then the decay time, we might go from 4 seconds to 2 seconds. We might drop that down so it won't flare as high and hold as high. It'll come right back down to idle and settle out. Let's kind of just experiment with this. It's just going to be just a little bit trial and error. So we're going to go ahead and fire it up. We're just going to pay attention to what this is going to do. Pay attention to the engine speed. Let me go ahead and just crank it over here. So it fires up to about 1200 and it gradually works its way down here. It's still about 1100, targets 900. So we can see it starts to kind of settle it out, and IEC position slowly drops its way down. What we can do here is actually bring it down to idle speed a little bit quicker. So the decay time, let's just say we want to decay it for 2 seconds, and the hold time, let's just do 2 seconds. Let me just demonstrate this real quick. Try this again, let it power on. And we might have to go back here and establish our USB link here. All right, let's try this again here. Now, it should go up and drop quicker and come right back into the target idle a little bit quicker. Let's try that. So it's going to settle down right to the target idle. So you can see how that kind of calls an effect. So it holds that position less at that IEC startup position, and then it decays it away and goes back to the normal IEC position where we would find on a warm idle. So just one thing to experiment with. Again, if you need more airflow under cranking, you may need to go into the IEC parts here and ramp up the airflow. So if you're giving it throttle to get it to start, you can go here into the IEC park position. Alternatively, you can also go after the cranking fuel. If we go down here into our startup enrichment, we see our cranking fuel. You might need less cranking fuel. Right now, they're commanding 7 pound per hour, which is gonna translate to a certain amount of injector pulse width under cranking. You might find that by reducing, if you're going and having to give it throttle under cranking, by reducing down the cranking fuel, you're gonna be leaning out the mixture under cranking. So by you opening your foot, you're leaning out the mixture, or you can alternatively lean out the mixture by actually injecting less fuel. You can go about it two different ways. So kind of keep that in mind. If it takes a lot of cranks to actually fire up, so it's crank, 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 and then it fires, without giving it throttle, you need more cranking fuel. You might have to jump in here and change these values. Usually the Holley values are pretty good starting points. Value of 7 here seems to work pretty well. We might be able to tweak this a little bit. Let's just see what's going to happen here and change it from 7 to 5. I don't know what's going to happen. We'll lower it down a little bit and just kind of see the cause and effect. Just play around with this. Again, experimentation is always something that you'd like to go ahead and do on your car. You can definitely be able to get the starting a little bit quicker. We're trying a little bit less fuel under cranking here. Let me crank it over. Cranks just like stock. Just like stock right there. So that proves that by lowering the cranking fuel, it is responding quicker. We have less fuel being pumped into the engine, and the engine's able to light off that mixture a little bit quicker. So by changing this a little bit, made a big difference in how quickly it cranked to fire. Now, it wasn't bad before, but it's even better now. A little bit of experimentation does not hurt, and we can see by lowering it down 2 pound per hour, it seemed to respond, and that is a pretty much instant starting. I'm not gonna go ahead and change that at all. I think that's going to be good. That's another factor to consider. One other thing I wanna talk about right here is going to be if we flip into
all. Thanks for checking out our teaser clip. If you want to see the rest of this video and more than 500 hours of current EFI training we have to offer, make sure you click right here. If you want to go and check out more teaser clips from this training course, click here. And you don't want to miss any of the videos we're going to be releasing on this channel, so make sure you subscribe and click here. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys later.